Section. Hallelujah. Well, I just came back from Nigeria. And I can see that people are really worshiping God back home. Because of cold, I know we are tired. But let me tell you something. The only thing that can change things is prayer. There's nothing else. So, if you know you are being released tonight, chant hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
There in Nigeria is like they can pray. Like, but when you get to America, you won't have time to pray anymore. Because America is wilderness. I'm gonna get there. I'll get there. America is wilderness, I'm telling you right now. Because it is a place where there is no neighbor. Though we come around in church once in a while, but there is no neighbor. It is a place where there is no hope. You don't even know, maybe tomorrow you are going to another step. But according to the word of God of today, that God remember me. Look, let me tell you something. God has been promising Abraham for so long.
If you
read your Bible very well, for so long, in Genesis chapter 12, he promised that I will bless you. I will make you a father to many nations. I will bless you, your family, your nation. You know, God didn't do anything. In Genesis chapter 13, he repeated himself. In Genesis chapter 14, same thing. Genesis chapter 15, that's the one that we read every Wednesday morning. He said, come now, come and look at the sky. That's how he said, from. And you know, for the funnest part of it, in Genesis chapter 17, and Abraham laughed. He was mocking God. After 25, you have been promising me. The only reason is promise. What kind of promise is this? He laughed. But things change around. I said tonight, things will change in your life.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something. If I'm praying like this, you need to say, I receive it. And you will jump. That's the only way. But go back in fear at you, Gilly. I mean, that's the power of God. When the power of God in you, you will change to be like a child or a boy of 15 years old that will just jump. I saw one man in Nigeria. I can't even believe it, because when they are releasing all this prayer session, if you see how he was jumping, but he's not him anymore. He has transformed. God will transform you. What am I saying? In Genesis chapter 18, things change around, and that laughter turned to something else. Your laughter will turn to something else. This is the first prayer point. You are no. I just stand before you to say all this prayer. But tonight, what was the time? 1 o'clock. By the time the sun rises, whoever that holds your glory shall be released in your life. That glory that has been taken away for the past 20 years, 25 years. So if God is saying, I will do this, I will do that, I will do this, I will do that. Wait for your time. Wait for your time.
Father,
free. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. That is how you obey. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. You are not there yet. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. In Jeremiah 31, 37, God said, if the covenant of day do not change, and if the covenant of night does not change, then the covenant, me, God, that I made with your family will never change. That's the word of God. Fire! Say that one more time. Fire!
Fire!
How can I have you as a father? I suffer in the land of America. Father, release me. Remember me. Jesus Christ, holy mighty, Father Almighty, by the word of God, who said, if the covenant of day does not change, and covenant of day does not change, oh, you celestial, my covenant will not change upon you, by your power, Almighty God. Father, release your power upon me, 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 release your power upon me. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. In the mighty name of God I pray. Amen. Amen. In Jesus' name. See, let me tell you something. Your enemy does not care of anybody. The only thing that he cares about is the anointing of God. And that's why you still pastors still fumble. They will still fumble. Shepherds will still fumble because they are human. Our president will still fumble. They are human. The only thing that he respects is the anointing of God. And that's why Jesus Christ in the book of Matthew, after 40 days and 40 nights, he was still tempted. Fire!
Fire!
Who are the enemies surrounded me?
Who are the enemies surrounded me?
To tempt me into slavery. Maybe you don't understand. Oh, better than. That's why I said, America is a wilderness. Don't think it's a land of me. It's a land. I've been in this country now 19 years. And I'm telling you, if I say 19 years, I'm telling you it's a wilderness. It's a wilderness because who knows? If I'm still in Nigeria, maybe I'll be one of the governor now. Who knows? But we want to come here because you don't have time to serve God. You cannot elevate. You cannot. No way. No way. Because you don't really have time to come on Wednesday, serve God. So how come you want to see the mercy of God or favor of God? No. But you really want to come. But your work will not allow you to come. It will not allow you to come. That's why I said, whatever temptation, my job or my, that I will not come to receive my glory. That's why I said, God, Father!
Father!
Father! Why would I suffer in this land?
This
great reviver.
Father,
release me.
Let
the bondage. Let the bond to ashes. One jar there. Jar. Jehovah. Jesus Christ, holy my King. Father Almighty. I'm in this land. Land of opportunity. But I'm still in the wilderness. Lord Almighty. Release me. Release me. In the blood of Jesus. Father, release me. Let your name be glorified. Let your name be glorified. All the enemies, let them be brought to righteous. All the power of them, let them be confounded. In the mighty name of God, Father, you can do it. 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 In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Say amen. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. In the mighty name of God, I pray.
Amen.
I'll sing this in Yoruba. So maybe someone can translate. I know some people don't speak Yoruba here. But there are some songs that if I don't sing my dialect,
Emi mi mo be mi wo o ti gbagbara de.
To empower me, and I need that sword. That's the only way I can conquer. Yeah, you will see whatever change. I mean, you must be angry or see. If we have all the anointing men of God here, Obuyo de Sheironi, you don't know, maybe it's you, you don't know, maybe it's me. So that's why any prayer, let me tell you this short story. Not knowing that the person that her name was in the Bible, she was the person that was playing. She was not serious. And the spirit of God, they should do it now. And some people sometimes when they come to a show like this, they don't care. They will be going out and, you know, back and forth. They don't know, maybe the time has come to release them. And they were praying, they are just playing. So that's why when the spirit of God is telling us to do something, please be in spirit. All the curse of death, God will destroy it. Yeah. And then it shall be destroyed. It shall be destroyed. Now you say one jar. That all the power that surrounded me, that will tie me. Because as long as you are tied, you cannot reach your glory. You cannot, because you are already tied. But you don't know, though you are walking. But we are talking spiritually. We are talking spiritually. Because Joseph, God showed him a big dream. Do you know that?
Yes.
He was shown a big dream. Joseph was shown a big dream. And that dream landed him into a pit. And he said, God, where are you? Ah, but he showed me that all these things are bowed down to my own glory. What's going on? And before he knew it, he was sold into slavery. Before he knew it, he made somebody. He said, yeah, maybe this person will be my helper. But no, he landed him into a jail again. I don't know who I'm talking to. I don't know. He landed him into a jail. But because God wants to show his glory in Joseph, he now made the king to have a troubled dream. The king was troubled. He was troubled. He could not sleep anymore. Because of, he wanted to bring something out from Joseph. He could not sleep. He could not rest. And God showed him that, what is going to happen in that city? And because God, our God is a good God, he now called somebody and said, you know what? I know somebody that can Let me stop right here before you say that prayer. Don't you know that you have your own destiny, you have your purpose in this life? But Satan will come. By the time you want to receive that thing that God wants to use you for, he will now come and tempt you. He may come in form of a man, he may come in form of a woman, and he will tempt you in such a way that you will lose that glory. That's why I want you to be. Somebody for Joseph, and God now told Joseph that this is the picture of everything. But none of this magician can interpret it, sir. None of them. Can you see? From pit, slavery, jail. So what are you going through? I don't know, as a shepherd. What are you going through as an accountant? What are you going through as a director? What can you have to be patient before God can remember you. And that book, Isaiah 46, 25, says there is no searching of his understanding. There is no searching of his understanding at all. He has the capacity to remember all of us. He has that capacity. By that moment, that the one that glory to be blossom is now called Joseph, that I will make you the second in command. It is not under the second in command, but he was in charge of financial and what?
And food.
In your power and power, Otiton. Oluwa!
Oluwa!
Yekere, Oluwa!
Oluwa!
Not in me! Oluwa!
Oluwa!
Cannot stand in one place. Yeah. For this song, if you stand, you are not ready to fight. And the Bible speak there. Because we are starting now, we are under the city fire to that barrier. At that time, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they told the king that even if our God refused to save us, we would not bow down. Not knowing that the fourth person is coming. The fourth person is coming to release them. All the power that is dragging you here and there, that is connecting with the one at home, connecting with the one in America, today they will be destroyed. And this is how you do it. And you just follow me. Raise up your one hand. And we'll be a blue there. You just say, Eli Christ l'a dit. Eli Eli, Eli Christ l'a dit. Eli Eli,
Eli Christ l'a dit.
Eli Eli,
Eli Christ l'a dit.
Eli Eli,
Eli Christ l'a dit.
Eli Eli,
Eli Christ l'a dit.
Eli Eli,
Eli Christ l'a dit.
Eli Eli,
Eli Christ l'a dit.
Eli Eli,
Eli Christ l'a dit.
As you raise up your head, that enough is enough. Father, rise with the power of authority from heaven. That power that releases Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego and the furnace fire. This is in my time. Whoever that banded my hand, that I will not make it in this land of living. Father Almighty, descend into my rescue. Seven jars, prayer. Jesus Christ, Holy Mighty, the time has come. Father, release me. Father, release me. Father, release me. All the power that is going to be released. Father, let them be confounded. Let them be destroyed. By the power of blood of Jesus Christ, let them be destroyed. 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 In Jesus' name, Father. Because of one fellow, God can remember somebody in city. Because of somebody, because of some, you don't know for the evangelism of John B coming to Minnesota. Maybe because of one person, because it happened in Mark chapter 10, verse 46. You know, God went to Jericho. He remembered that man, a blind man, and he spoke a word in his life. And I want you to come in with God now. All the world. Jesus Christ, Holy Mighty, you are not in. To be said, 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 to remember people there. Remember what happened in the book of Mark chapter 1. There was this man that has been completely captured by demons. He was completely captured. He could not do anything. And his purpose was supposed to be an evangelist. An evangelist. If I want to back up people that are in Tafel Logue, Funny, and Tafel Logue, Subama Shakini, what do you wear? What But immediately that he saw Christ, and that's why I said, the only name that they recognize is Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That's the name. And I want you to chant that Jesus, and I will not until I jingle that bell. I just want you to continue chanting that name. Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, save me. Jesus Christ, save me. That this morning, this in 7 days. Hallelujah. Listen to me. I will tell you before you. I won't go. You want to go, madam. Let me tell you something. But in 7 days, at most 21 days, that after that, revival. You go back to doctor. You can't see no more. You can't see no more. You party and move about. She party 190. Timothy she 100. No one new job. I was up over 60. But when God remembered you, he will come and he will visit that sickness and he will lay your hand. And in Luke chapter 7:11, there was a woman who had only one child, but when Christ Christ remembered it. He taught that one. Calves. And then the man woke up immediately. So his name is Jesus. Jesus never failed. He never failed. Jesus never
fails.
Jesus never fails. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you. Let me tell you something before you call that Jesus. If you are calling something else, I don't know. Because if you are calling Jesus and you are calling Eriboya, Mamiya. He told them that do not have any other God except him. But because people cannot wait, that's why they ran to other gods. But I assure you tonight, whatever that your predicament is, whatever that your problem is, in this way, you shall be released in Jesus' name. So now you want to try, do you want to breathe in and out? Because it's going to be a very short exercise. And that short exercise, believe me, it will release you.
Amen.
Go to doctor said, don't worry, go to the gym. Just continue that thing. But this is a gym in the Lord. This is an exercise in that Lord, spiritual exercise. By the time you are shouting Jesus, whatever sickness, where it is, that want to cut your life short, that want to cut that life short, that will not let you fulfill that purpose. And there are many purposes that God has created you, that you will still see your, and you come back, like, oh, I want to go to your bank, I'm going to go, I'm going to go, I want to go to your bank, So definitely we must see it, and the only way you can see it is by the power of God of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, 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 Jesus Christ,
Oh man, I give you a duro bye bye. Oh man,
to pay your chauffeur. No, you are to do. Oh, man, you need to do my mind.
There is nothing God cannot do. I want to refer you to 2 Kings chapter 4. There was a woman, and that woman was in heavy debit. It was very heavy. Being about what you be seen. Because she refused to pray. Go and read it. Go and research it very well. She refused to pay until the creditor now sent some people that, you know what, we will take your children. And she began to pray. She began to pray. Sometimes God, when God wants to move, He will shake the heaven. He will shake the heaven. Because she prayed and God acted quickly. And I want God to add quickly tonight.
Amen.
It's going to be three different prayers on that one. We pay Bobo Bessie. Don't show me so well. Go jump me 2, 3, 4. Go buy your. In your king be. Remember 2, 3, 4. Why do not have a meal? Me, whatever my bin. Tim, I need you in the world. You see some people, 2, 3, 4. They don't even know. Maybe it was a good news or a bad news. Now, 2, 3, 4. No. So, 2, 3, 4 is a call from Nigeria. Because you want to ask me money again. Money. And you are in the land of money. I mean, because I remember when I was coming to America, I thought they would just look at three. I began to calculate that. That is a wilderness. That you will walk. You will walk. And that's why people. Oluwa!
Oluwa!
That's the only way God can remember you. Yes. That's the only way even your neighbor, your friends can remember you. Yes. And I will refer you to 1 Samuel 17. Though David was anointed, but it's within his family. It was not made known to everybody. No! It was not made. God might be promising you that you're going to be this, you're going to be that. But something must announce you.
Yes.
Until he fought with, in Genesis 17, he fought with Goliath and won. And in Genesis, in 1 Samuel 17, and 1 Samuel 18, 7 and 8, then the woman announced that he killed 10,000. Even at work, no matter profession that you are, no matter, somebody must proclaim your work. And that is a good prayer point. That something that will proclaim your prayer, that everybody will know you all over the world. Proclaim your name. Somebody must tell somebody. Somebody must tell somebody. Somebody must tell somebody until you be remembered.
Amen.
Because Kosin did your ba. And Kodesin Kotaleshisi. Anybody to party while your ba woman job and money. Unless go and check it. Tell me about Julie Shabuto. It didn't happen on my children's family. Because when they still over the break, only any shape. Only any right. Only they get you food. How they get you food? Let us take this thing seriously. There's nothing you can. Baba Bush, put your president. Because it didn't your body. I don't know where you've come from. I don't know your generation. If your generation have been suffering, maybe in the history you have been suffering, you can break that curse. You can break it. And if that generation is the family of glory, then that glory must not stop. Father! Whatever will stop my glory!
Whatever will stop my glory!
Number three. Come on, back on remember you. Thank you. Number one, your tools will be your hand. Your tools may be your leg, your eye. And when Baba don't call it, don't buy no reshape on you, joking in your long ways in the car. In the car, in your. Kole, your own bad phone, Titi. In reshape, you're going to shoot my long booty. Oh, you fuck to in reshape, you're going to black. Come on, put on back, be the best, you're going to show back, but one more in reshape, one budget. You're going to sash him. You're going to get back, Bradon. Kota, you're going to come and she want to lose me. If you will leave, man. We are talking about that truth. In spiritual realm, these people will come and break it. You don't have tools, you can't do anything. Even you, I'm going to go to the hospital.
5 o'clock.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You will have opposition.
Yes.
So I'm telling you the truth. Yes. And a lot of us cannot stand opposition.
Yes.
Because you oppose me, because of that, I'm leaving this church. Because you oppose me, because of that, I'm leaving this church. And that's the first lesson last Sunday. God said, if you are falling, won't you rise? If you can overcome that opposition, then you are stepping into glory. Let me tell you something. As this church is beautiful, as this church is, if anything break into that church, step up. Let us lock it. Come back to break. You want to jump for lamps? Come back to break. And yeah, they catch the camera. Nobody did the camera. I only want to down here. They will. That opposition will teach you how to pray. Because if you don't have that opposition, you will not do anything. Because of that opposition, that's what will be like injection that will give you the power. And you know, to say that as a child, I need to pray. Father, let me overcome all my opposition.
Take
me into new glory. Remember me, O Lord. I know this one. This will be the last one. Listen to it. A lot of people, sometimes they don't overcome it. But in Jesus' name, we will overcome it.
Amen.
And I'll start with this. Moses was called in the wilderness because he left Egypt because of the atrocity. But God met him in the wilderness. And God told him that, you know what, I want to send you on an errand, go back. But before you go, I will give you this, I will empower you. And God showed him face to face that I am with him. And he saw it. And he went back to Egypt. And he tried everything that he could. Anytime that God wants to fool us with the Israelites, he will beg God. But you know what happened? The forest power of Egypt, God used him for all this glory, for all this miracle. He parted the Red Sea. He commanded the water. He did everything. But he ended everything in the wilderness. He did not get into the promised land. With the power, you can be powerful.
Yes.
I'm telling you, For those of you that is looking at TV, Jonathan, there is glory in this church.
Oh yes.
It's not that they knew that there's glory in the church. And the only Ogun to one Shesiwa, Nita, Ejekomabarawaja. Kishosh, what they say short, Kijoy back, meeting their brother. We are in the wilderness. Do we want to end up in the wilderness with all this great power? That's why I said a lot of people don't make it. They don't. After working many years, Mama Minua did you know? Moses, I'm telling you, because immediately I got to America, how many years? I couldn't even go. Ewa wo si kan boti ewa se ba ma tojo omo ku sinu agiju ah oluwa
oluwa
o so ni o ni atara ejeje jesu
baba ki be kale
eyi jesu eyi jesu eyi I should not die, but live to achieve, but live